Hello people, welcome back once again to another video of my channel Flying Trucker. In this video, I'm going to be talking in English. The reason why I'm going to talk in English because in my previous video, I have been bombarded with this question regarding how flight training in Canada looks like. What are the steps involved? How much does it cost? So a lot of people ask me these questions. So I have decided to make this tiny little video talking about how does a flight training in Canada look like. Also, if you guys have seen my previous video, none of the videos had any subtitles, so making this video in English kind of saves me time on typing all the subtitles. Okay, so if anyone wants to know more about how flight training in Canada looks like, stick on. Hey, so if anyone is watching this video or coming to this channel for the first time, hello, my name is Anish. Here I am talking how a flight training looks like in Canada. What are the steps involved? How much does it cost? I'm not gonna get into very detailed information on how the entire training looked like, but kind of give you a little insight into how the whole training process looks like in Canada. So before I begin, I just want to say I'm not an immigration officer, so do not ask me questions like how to get the visa, how do I come to this country, all this kind of stuff. But based on my experience, how it worked out for me was I picked this specific flight school and I just emailed them. They gave me this application letter, which I filled it out, and then they gave me this acceptance letter with which I went to an immigration agent. He kind of helped me out fill those forms. If you want, you can do it online by yourself. It's all up to you, right? So that's how I did it. I don't know what the rules and regulations are right now, so I'm not going to talk about that. And I know there might be some people who are watching this video hoping that they might get some information on how to convert the Canadian license to their home country license. Pretty sure a lot of people from India are also watching this video thinking about converting the Canadian license to DGCA. Well, a big disappointment for you guys, because I have absolutely zero knowledge on that information, so I'm not gonna be talking about that. So sorry guys. And at the same time, I'm not gonna pick on any flight school specifically, because picking a flight school or choosing what flight school you wanna go to is completely depending upon you, right? There might be various factors depending on which you wanna pick a flight school, right? For example, the first and the main important factor being the cost, right? People wanna spend less, at the same time get a good quality training, right? Another factor could be the location, right? Sometimes you might be in Canada or you have family in Canada in Swanso province, so probably you want to go to that province so you can stay with the family and then go do your flight training, right? Another reason could be immigration, because there are some provinces that promotes immigration and makes it a little more quicker than the other provinces. So if that's your priority, probably do your research and then see what flight school works out good for you. So like I said, just it's completely up to you, depending on what kind of the reason or the priority based on what you want to pick a flight school, right? So anyways, regardless of whatever flight school you pick, the training procedure, the steps involved are pretty much the same, because all these rules have been laid out by regulating aviation authority called Transport Canada. So all the steps are going to be the same regardless of what flight school you go to. Alright, now let's jump into the main topic. So to begin with, the first set of license you need to do is private pilot license. For this, a category 3 is good enough, but I would highly recommend go get a category 1, because that's what you need eventually for your commercial license, right? So get a category 1 license, it's pretty much straightforward. And until and unless you don't have any medical complications, should not be a problem. So private pilot license is the first thing that you want to do. Takes about 2 to 3 months. Again, the time period, it all depends on you, how fast you want to do it, how slow you want to do it. If you're doing it part-time, obviously it's going to be longer, right? The requirements, again, like I said, I'm not going to get into detail about what the requirements are like, but I'm just going to brush on what it kind of looks like, so that kind of gives you an idea. So the minimum requirements that you need for your private pilot license is 33 hours of dual flight. So Dual flight, what does it say? Dual flight, as the word implies, dual means two people, which means an instructor is sitting with you, teaching you how to fly the plane, right? So first time you come into this flight school or learning how to fly, you don't know how to fly. So someone has to teach you. So the instructor sitting with you, teaching how to fly, that's gonna cost you about $250 per hour. So $250, again, that depends on what kind of plane you train on, right? There are mostly schools go for cheaper training planes like Cessna 152 or a Cessna 172, so the cost hover somewhere around 250, 275, whatever it is, right? But the cheaper version is a Cessna 150, should cost you around $250 per hour. There are also fancy planes like a DF-40, which obviously is gonna cost you more than $250, right? So it all depends on what kind of plane you train on, but an average cheaper plane costs you about $250 per hour. The next requirement is 12 hours of solo flight, again solo by yourself. So those are the minimum requirements that you need to hit. The solo flight costs you about $160 per hour, again in a 152, a Cessna 152. Another requirement is 5 hours of instrument time. Instrument time is where you put this hood on top of your head, so you're not looking outside, you're looking inside on the instrument gauges of your plane and then flying. That can also be done partially on a simulator, but again, flying is different, simulator is different, but if you want to cut cost, you can always do in a simulator too. But so these are the minimum requirements, but not many people do finish on the minimum requirements. They take a little more. So on an average, it costs about $13,000 to $16,000. Yes. Now, probably if you do the math, it doesn't add up to $13,000 because there are other fees and other stuffs included in this. But an average, someone who's doing a private pilot license is looking to spend about $13,000 to $16,000. Now, why is there a vast difference between the amount? Because I'll explain. There are some people who are good at flying, they might catch up things pretty quick, right? Now let's say you and your instructor go up for an exercise, right? There are a certain number of exercises that you need to complete to get your license done. So now you and your instructor go up to get your to do an exercise, and for some reason you don't do good. So then what happens? You need to go for another 1 more hour, right? So that's like almost 2 hours for one exercise. So 2 hours of flying cost you about $500. But then those 2 hours that you spend up in the air can be added, or is supposed to be added, onto your logbook. So your hours get added, but then the money that you're spending gets a little more pricey because you're spending more money. So that's how you might end up somewhere between $13,000 to $16,000. This is the average amount. People could end up spending more than $16,200, or people could end up spending less than $13,000. It's all up to you how prepared you are for your flight, right? So $30,000 to $60,000 is what you need for private pilot license. Again, this license has a written exam which has 4 topics which you need to complete to get the license signed off. So usually what happens after you get your private pilot license is you can take anyone for flying. You can take your girlfriend, you can take your friend, you can take your mom, dad, anyone for flying. You can fly around, you can go to the States, you can fly all around Canada. So much fun time. But usually what happens once you do your private pilot license, what you're supposed to do is something called a night training, so you can fly at night, because you don't want to go during the daytime and then get stuck because you cannot fly at night, right? So that's why you do a night training, which is going to cost you about $3,000. So after that, people do something called the time building. You need to build time. So the requirements for a commercial pilot license is 200 hours in total. Out of that, 100 hours has to be solo hours. So for this 100 solo hours, you're building your time, right? So I've approximated about 20 hours of solo flight is what you're going to spend for your private, and about 30 hours of solo training is what you need for your commercial. So that's a total of 50 hours, right? So total you need 100 hours. So another 50 hours is what I'm approximating for your time building. So 50 hours of solo flight is going to cost you $160 per hour. Total cost is going to come up to $7,000 to $8,000. Again, all depends on what kind of plane you fly, right? So now let's say you did your private, you did your night trading, you had fun doing time building, all good. Now is the time either, so what usually people do is they decide to go for your commercial flight test, right? So again, the commercial flight test has another written exam, 4 topics again, which you need to finish. So once you do that, you can do your flight test. The flight test requirements are 35 hours of dual flight, 30 hours of solo flight, 20 hours of instrument time. So all this is gonna cost you about $15,000. Okay, So usually this is what people do, private night trading, time building, and then they get their commercial pilot license. So to get your commercial pilot license signed off, you need the total requirement, which is 200 hours in total and 100 hours solo flight. If you don't meet that, you will not get your license signed off. Doing a flight test is a different thing. Getting your license is a different thing, right? Doing your flight test doesn't mean you get your commercial license. To get the license signed off, you need to meet the requirements. So another set of rating is called multi-engine rating, or IFR, multi-engine IFR rating. So clearly the word says multi, which means you are going to be flying a plane with two engines. So you need this rating later on if you want to fly a plane with two engines, right? So you need this multi-engine rating. So that's going to cost you about $5,000 to $7,000, and the cost per flight is going to cost you $400. It's a little expensive. And the multi IFR, where you are flying in this two engine plane, but IFR means instrument flying rules, so you need to get that rating to be able to fly in clouds. There's another written exam for that too, so you need to clear that. Instrument flying rules, yes, so you need to get that to in order to fly in clouds or above clouds. So that's going to cost you about $9,000 to $11,000. So people can do this multi rating and IFR together, or do it separately. It's all up to you. Another way of saving money is probably doing your multi IFR as a part of your whole commercial license. Now what do I mean by that? Okay, now a couple of different ways you can do it, right? So do your private, do your time building, night trading, do your commercial flight test, and then get it signed off. So now with 200 hours you have your commercial pilot license, right? Now another way of saving money is, let's say you do your private, time building, night trading, time building, and then you do your commercial flight test. Now you're left with another, probably let's say your total time is about 180 hours, right? So now you need another 20 more, let's say dual time is left. So now instead of going flying with an instructor just like that, just to meet the requirements, rather why not do your multi-engine IFR, so that once you hit about 200 hours, you have your multi-engine, multi-IFR all together with your commercial once you hit the 200 hours. So that's how you kind of end up saving money, because again, as you can see in the commercial pilot license, it says one of the requirements is 20 hours of instrument time, right? So now rather flying these 20 hours just for your commercial, the instrument time just for your commercial, you could use that 20 hours for your multi-engine instrument rating, right? So you can use that to fulfill the requirements for your commercial. So what I'm trying to say is, by the time you hit about 200 hours, you have your commercial and your multi-IFR all together within the 200 hours. Because if we go the other way around, if you want to finish your commercial first with all 200 hours and then go for your multi-rating after that, so that's going to add another 30 hours on top. So you end up having 230 hours. So you might end up spending a little more. Might. But again, this is a decision that you don't have to make right now, because you need to come here, experience, and then see how the scenario is, and then decide, right? Because in order to make a decision, you need all the information. So don't decide right now, okay? Just take it easy always, because again, at the same time, if you're thinking about saving money in aviation, it's not the best option, because saving money is going to be hard. In order to save money, all what I can say is you need to be prepared and proactive for every lesson that you go up for flying. But anyways, see, these are the two ways you can do it. Either you can get your commercial license done first, then go for your multi-IFR later on, or do this multi-IFR and commercial all together at once. The other thing is, like, the multi-engine plane costs about $400, right? So if you go up there, if you screw up things, and if you're have to go up again, so that's like 400 plus 400 2 hours, you're looking to spend about $800. That's a lot of money. So that's why some of them, they're like, you know, taking it easy, they'll just get the commercial signed off, take it easy, get some experience, come back, and then do the multi-IFR too. So it's all up to you how you want to do it, right? Now let's say you have a job lined up flying a single engine plane. You don't need your multi-engine or IFR rating. So all what you need to do is get your commercial done, signed off, go get the job, fly the plane, get experience, get some extra flying hours, then come back, and then probably multi-engine IFR would be a piece of cake for you, right? Again, all depends what or how you want to do it, right? The other thing, the other rating what people usually do is something called the instructor rating. Instructor rating, as the word clearly says, it's about how to be an instructor. The amount that you're looking to spend is about $30,000 to $15,000. Now, Not many people want to do this, but there are some people who want to do this just to get the time to build hours, right? So before you do this, you want to think, sit back and think, do I want to be an instructor? Because being an instructor is not easy, and this rating as such is also not easy, because in this rating you need to be good at flying, you need to be good at teaching, and also at the same time you need to judge how the other person is flying. So there's so many skills involved in this rating, so it's not easy. And the biggest irony here is the people with the least amount of experience usually goes for instructor rating. So that's how the industry is. But like I said, before you want to do this rating, just think about it, because this involves another $10,000 to $15,000 of cash that you need to add on to your training. So think about it. But people do this rating so that they can get a jump start and be an instructor right away and then build hours quickly too. But then if you have another job lined up, so you don't even need to bother about doing instructor rating. Anyways, I hope I haven't confused you all. Now coming to the fun part, the total money that you're looking to spend in flight training as such. All right, so I've summed up all the amount here. For PPL, you're looking to spend about $15,000. Night training is going to cost you about $3,000. CPL is going to cost you about $15,000. Time building in that is going to cost you about $8,000. Now, if that's all what you want to do, you can do the math and see how much does it add up to. But later on, you need to get a multi-engine and IFR rating, because eventually you will be have, I don't know what you have plans for, but eventually if you want to fly a plane with two engines, you need to get those multi, and if you want to fly in clouds, you need to get those IFR rating too. So that's going to cost you about $15,000. So total cost is going to be around $56,000. That's what you're looking to spend. Now let's say if you want to add instructor rating on top of that, that's another $14,000. So your total is going to come up to about $70,000 Canadian. Yeah. So like I said, instructor rating is not mandatory. It's only if you want to be an instructor. And at the same time, to be an instructor, you do not need multi IFR. You can also be an instructor right after commercial. You finish your commercial, you get your commercial license signed off, you can right away do your instructor rating. You don't need a multi IFR. So depending on what you want to do, how you want to do your money, the spending is going to be depending on how you want to do it, right? So, but anyways, total, if you want to do the whole thing, instructor, multi-IFR, all that stuff, 70,000 is what you're looking at. Again, this is not solid prices I'm talking about. It could go up, it could go down. Again, schools keep on changing their prices, so this is an approximate number, just kind of to give you guys an idea how much you would be looking forward to spend, right? So that's pretty much it that I wanted to talk to you guys about. And if you guys did like it, please hit the like button. And if you guys have any questions, please do type it down on the comments, so hopefully I can answer those questions. And if you guys want to know more about this, like what the job prospects looks like, or should I say it did look like, because of COVID pandemic, I don't know what the future of aviation is going to be looking like, but I can obviously tell you what did it look like before pandemic. And if you guys want to know what kind of jobs are available out here in Canada, and also how much do you get paid, right? After spending all this big bucks, how much do you obviously want to see how much are you getting paid as a pilot, right? So if you guys want to know all that information, please do type it down below, so then I can make another video on that. That's all what I have to say for this video. I hope you enjoyed the video. Again, hit the like button if you did. Share it to all your friends, all the aviation people who want or who are looking to do aviation in Canada. Until next time, you guys take care. Bye-bye. Be safe.